Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. We're going to do just one quick example at the end of this playlist of how we can look at different factors that affect charge stabilization. On top of the screen, we have acetic acid, and it is reacting with a base. It's reacting as an acid. It's being deprotonated to form this charged conjugate base. And the pKa for this particular reaction is 4.7, and we'd say, yeah, this is 4.7. That indicates our acid is a moderate acid. And the reason it's moderate is because our anion is fairly well stabilized, in this case, by resonance in the conjugate. Oops, that's not conjugate acid, that's conjugate base. In our conjugate base. So let's look at the next reaction. Next reaction is the same. It's called thioacetic acid. We can deprotonate this. It gives us a negative charge on the sulfur. And we'd say, wow, this acid should be more acidic because the conjugate base should be a more stable species, a weaker base, because it has this large anion. So this should be a size effect. And sure enough, this acid on the left is more acidic, has a pKa of about 3.4. It's a stronger acid because the conjugate base is weaker. It's weaker because the anion is stabilized through a size effect of that sulfur. Now, the bottommost species, again, we have some type of acetic acid. It's called chloroacetic acid. The base breaks that OH bond, removes a proton, puts the bonding pair as a new lone pair on our oxygen. We get this anion, and we would expect that this particular conjugate base would be stabilized somewhat by this polarized carbon-halogen bond, carbon-chlorine bond, and this would be an inductive effect. So here we have not a size effect, but induction, polarization of that carbon-chlorine bond. That would make the resulting anion more stable, less reactive, less basic, a weaker base, which means the original acid should be a stronger base. And in fact, it is. It's about pKa 2.8, 2.9. So notice that in the middle case, we had a size effect, and in the bottom case, we had an example of an induction or an inductive effect. It's hard to predict which one of these is going to have the bigger impact, but both of them did have an impact because both of these acids are more acidic than our parent acid. That doesn't mean we can always say, oh, well, the inductive effect is always bigger or the size effect is always stronger. We just have to see examples. But at least we can recognize from this acid, if we put in a sulfur, that's going to make it more acidic through a charge through a size effect. And if we put a chlorine on our carbon, we're going to get an inductive effect. And both of those will lead to stronger acids because we get weaker conjugate bases.